This is Naomi. She likes dancing, milkshakes, football, hanging out with her friends, and her hamster, Echo. She writes songs and plays the drums in a band, but she's shy and doesn't like playing in front of people. Naomi lives with her mom and dad, Echo, and her little brother, Alex. At school, she likes English, art, music, and making things. But when it comes to chemistry, physics, or biology, this is what happens to Naomi's brain. Naomi's clever, but she's just not really into science. As a girl whose family is not highly educated, she's about 3.5 times less likely to connect with science than her male peers from highly educated families. But as she grows up, Naomi will be faced with a world totally transformed by new technologies, by artificial intelligence, big data, global health crisis, climate change, a world where science literacy will be power. Non-formal education centers can make the difference, awakening an interest that doesn't take root at school. The trouble is, museums and all that, they're just not Naomi's thing. But Naomi's local science museum has been rethinking the way it communicates and connects with learners as part of its commitment to equity, developing its outreach and putting learners at the center of its programming. So it was while Naomi was scrolling through new dance routines on TikTok that she came across a video about a mobile science lab coming out to her neighborhood. Her parents took her along with her brother, and they had a go at light painting. Naomi's dad looked hilarious wearing the VR headset, but his light paintings were actually pretty good. Naomi's brother Alex enjoyed it so much, he said he'd like to have a go at the new science museum. Well, it's not really new. They'd just never been before. Their dad always said it was too expensive. But now it's free on Saturdays, you can catch the number 70, there's good wheelchair access, and they even have a quiet hour. Alex doesn't like too much noise. Naomi doesn't go. Museums are boring. And anyway, she's got band practice at Anna's most Saturdays. After practice, Naomi and the girls love arguing about singers and samples and drummers, and wonder about what makes some songs so satisfying to hear again and again and again. Back at home, Naomi hears Alex talking about the brain imaging exhibit he saw at the Science Museum and how it lit up in response to his thoughts. Naomi asks Anna if she'd like to see it. Hooked up to the imaging system, they go through their playlist and watch as their brains respond to each song. They chat to Chen, the neuroscientist running the exhibit, and she tells them about the way the brain's pleasure centers and motor areas respond to anticipation and familiar sounds. Chen is the first real scientist Naomi has ever met. Now at the weekends, Naomi and the band often go to the science museum. They can drop in whenever they like to check out what's going on and hang out with whoever is there. Christina from the museum asks Naomi, Anna, and the others if they want to join a co-creation session to design a new program. Naomi can't stand the thought of having to do a presentation about her ideas, but feels much happier when she finds out that she can make a zine to share her thoughts. Back at school, and Naomi's in science class, hiding behind her books and making a new playlist. But when her teacher tells her they'll be exploring photons and wave particles, Naomi sits up. She's starting to realize that science is all around her, and it's amazing.